imagine there's a tree. A big, huge banana tree. Full green. And now, do not imagine a monkey sitting on that tree. Do not imagine the monkey wearing a red sweater and saying a hi to you. Do not. There is a tree, but there is no monkey on it. And the monkey who is wearing a red sweater is not sitting on the tree. And the monkey wearing a red sweater has a beautiful tail with a purple ribbon on it, but it is not sitting on the tree. You have to not imagine the monkey. Open your eyes. What did we see?
I saw only one.
We forgot that most of us, it is a very usual case that the mind is not in our control. Okay. Whatever we are doing, if we are working executives, if we are college students, we are provided with certain targets, with time limits. Happen? Okay, suppose we have to complete a certain task in 1 hour. Okay. To complete the task in 1 hour, we require a proper amount of concentration and focus. Otherwise, it won't get completed in an hour. Happens? Yes. But when we see, like while doing that task or while sitting in the class, let it be while sitting in the class, our mind is fully concentrated for just some amount of time. Happens? Like if it's an hour class and you all are sitting with ma'am and sir here. Okay. So like if it's a 1 hour class, 10-15 minutes you are like, today, you know, you look at this class, I'll bang it on with full concentration and full attention. Happens. But after some time, your mind goes somewhere. Happens. Yeah, all those smiling faces I can see happens. So where does it go? The question is, where does it go? To another thought. What kind of thoughts? Okay, sorry, I won't ask that. But yeah, to another thoughts. Happens. So see, your mind has this tendency to fluctuate. Okay, it will either go in the past or it will either go in the future. Happens? So when it goes in the past, certain emotions come. That's why you are gone, because certain emotions come. But when it goes in the future, certain emotions come. So let us now talk about emotions. What kind of emotions do pop in when you think about your past? Sometimes, what were the days? Nostalgia, oh my god. Happens? Yeah? Sometimes some regrets. If I had done it like that. Happens? Sometimes you start missing something. Okay, so you are really sad and this becomes this. Happens? You know, researchers have said that all those who are superly, amazingly successful, just one thing was common in them. Guess what? That their mind was always in the present moment. And when your mind is in the present moment, you are focused and relaxed at the same time. Isn't it a good idea? To be focused and relaxed at the same time. Now, what is this focus and relaxation? Like, you have to be focused, but how can you be relaxed? Confusing. So, again, a demo on this. So, imagine as your targets. You have some target which you have to achieve after a month. Okay, the target you have to achieve is after a month. What is the state of mind right now? Relaxed. 1 month. Right? Focused? No focus, right? Because you're not thinking what you have to do, you're just relaxed. Now imagine you have to complete the target in next 15 days. Relaxation level reduces. Okay, planning starts. Concentration level increases. Right. Now imagine tomorrow is the final date when you have to finally complete it. What is the relaxation level? Zero? Zero? And the concentration level? Maximum. That time are you happy? Or you just start throwing your files, become like, you know, don't show me your face, you know, go away, I have so much of work to do. Happens, stress pops in, worry pops in, anxiety pops in, relaxation level, zero. Concentration level, maximum. And that is also not sure now you'll be able to complete your target or not. So once this has happened in all of your life, how many of you have watched a movie? Everyone, I guess. Anyone who hasn't? Everyone has watched a movie. So when you go to buy this ticket for the movie, does the person sitting on the counter tells you, you know, you have to be full concentrated while watching the movie. See, with full focus and attention. Does he? But you do. You're fully concentrated in the movie. You're so focused that you remember the story forever and ever. Revisions of the songs are done like 100 times. Happens? Yeah. Were you relaxed while watching the movie? Yes. Since you were relaxed, you were concentrated, were you happy? Or were you crying? Like, leave the emotional scenes apart. But while seeing the movie, were you happy? Yes, you went for your enjoyment. Okay, so right now we will just play a
yes.
From the back. Yes?
Yes?
Yes? Okay, so this game is called the clap game. Okay, so now what are the instructions? The instructions are very simple. The moment I say clap, you always start clapping. The moment I say stop, you always stop. Okay. For that clapping, what do you need? You need your hands. Everyone has? Okay. Another rule is that you just have to clap using both your hands. You do not have to clap on the person sitting next to you. Okay, not on the rooftop. Okay? Are we in? So your weapons in front, please. And the clap has to be loud enough. Okay, it's morning, let's wake everybody. Good?
Yep.
Instructions are clear?
Yep.
So come on, let's start the game. 1, 2, 3, start! Come on! What were the instructions?
You didn't say clap.
Yeah, I didn't say clap. I said start. Do you see the level of focus and concentration? It doesn't matter how loud a person is. What all matters is what were the instructions. And people who were looking at me, that ma'am didn't say clap, also got influenced, right? You did not stuck to your decision that no, the what were the instructions? I'm not following it, I should stop. But you didn't. Happened? Let's give it to another. So what were the instructions? The instruction is when clap is said, you have to clap, 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 clap. Okay.